Let's turn to other news now. A newly appointed All Blacks coach, Ian Foster, is already talking about change and fresh ideas. He was announced this afternoon as the team's new head coach, replacing Steve Hansen, who stepped down following the All Blacks' third-place finish at the World Cup. The 54-year-old steps into the top job after 8 years as an assistant under Hansen and has vowed to add his own flavour to the national side. Mr. Foster fronted the media in his new role for the first time this afternoon and spoke to rugby reporter Joe Porter about how he's ready to step out of Hansen's shadow and be his own man, and why he thinks he's the right fit for the job.
Look, I had a clear plan, and I had the pretty good diagnosis of where the team's at and what we need to do to change to get better, and I was really confident with that. I felt I've injected some new voices in places that I think is going to be really, really important, and can't tell you about that now, but we will soon. And so I felt good about the proposal that I put forward, and I'm sure Scott felt good about his, and I'm sure it would have been outstanding too. And really, it was just ultimately it's their decision, isn't it?
Having spent 8 years in the All Blacks setup already obviously gives you an edge in terms of being able to, I guess, talk to what it's like to be there, and you know the requirements to be in that environment. But also, you would have had to bring a lot of freshness too, and a fresh approach, because otherwise there's the risk of, I guess, things becoming stale. So how did you, convince New Zealand Rugby, your bosses, that you had fresh ideas that you could bring to an environment that you'd already been in for 8 years?
Yeah, look, it's always, I was chuckling before the process about people saying it was a big advantage, and in some ways it is, but if you go and try and copy and paste, you're stuffed, aren't you? Yeah. So, and I knew that, and I knew that because I knew it wasn't the way forward for this team anyway. We did actually need a few new ideas, and it's a great opportunity to add some new voices. And, we've been, I think, led by a great man for 8 years. He did a fantastic job, but he's got his style, and it's an art to show that I could offer my style, and my style is different, and the way I talk, the way I present things, the way I think about the game, there'll be lots of little changes in it, and particularly, I guess, in the coaching group there's going to be changes, and it's another area of excitement for me because we've got a chance to inject some new fresh thinking in it, but we've got, I guess, my knowledge of where we've been and what we've achieved, and I can use that as a measurement stick.
I guess you've won your bosses over, now you have to win the public over, the New Zealand rugby public. What are you going to do to, I guess, show them a little bit more of Ian Foster?
Yeah, look, it's she's not a popularity contest, isn't it? You don't do this job to win mates, but it's, look, and I know that there's been so much debate because of the passion that's involved with this team, and clearly there was a lot of support for Scott, and I know that, and rightly so, and I guess now, but decision's been made. And so whilst I feel for him, and I know he'd be disappointed, and I know that he would have loved the opportunity, it's an opportunity that I've been handed. And now I guess people just have to sort of trust that process and know that get him behind the team. And my job is to show people that we have got a bit of freshness to this All Black team, and there will be some changes. But more importantly, I think the public want to see a team that want to represent them with a massive degree of pride and passion and skill, and do it with a smile on their face.
You talked about restoring a bit of mana to the All Blacks team after the World Cup. What did you mean by that?
Well, look, I think we played some great rugby at the World Cup, and I think we're probably, in many ways, one of the better attacking teams there. We played well. We, had a couple of outstanding games, but we lost a big game against England, and I think that we've received a lot of support from home about how we dealt with that, and how we responded in that Welsh game, and I guess we've got a little bit of mana as a team for the way we dealt with the disappointment, but the facts are is that we lost on the park and we didn't want to, and we've got to get that back. We love being the number one team in the world, and right now we're not.
You've taken over from Steve. Do you get to take any of his other possessions, his car, his house, or anything like that?
I might bid on the auction, but I'm not sure I'm quite at that level yet.
And that's the new All Blacks coach, Ian Foster, speaking to our rugby reporter, Joe Porter.